Guru Nation, I wanted to do a short and quick stock, BCRX, BioCryst Pharmaceuticals. We did a longer one on this on the Clinical Research Circle. It caught my attention. I was probably one of the only people on, although I convinced my business partner, Chris, to actually look at this stock as well. And we both ended up getting some of this stock after doing that video. But this is one that... you may say, hey, we missed it. We're late. What are you doing? This stock has had a run up from December. It was in the fives. Now it's $17. Why did that happen? Well, they actually had an approval in December 2020 for ORLADEYO to reduce or eliminate attacks in HAE patients. So what is that exactly? Well, let's get into the article really quick that we wrote on Latinos in Clinical Research so we can kind of get an overview over this company. I think this run-up that you've seen is nothing compared to what's possible, especially because of BCX9930, oral factor D inhibitor. So this can go from 17 to 170, honestly. Now, this is just in phase 1/2, pivotal trials to commence second half of 2021. What does phase 1/2 means? It means it's the first in human, but they're actually not doing it on healthy volunteer. They're going to be doing it on the actual patients with PNH is going to be the first one. Let's look at what BioCryst actually says about complement-mediated diseases. What is complement-mediated diseases? Well, you can either Google it or you can let BioCryst explain it for you. The complement system is part of the body's natural immune system and is responsible for helping the body eliminate microbes and damaged cells. Excessive or uncontrolled activation of the complement system can cause severe and potentially fatal immune and inflammatory disorders. Factor D is an essential enzyme in the alternative pathway, thus making factor D an attractive target to address complement-mediated diseases. I went on Wikipedia to look up complement-mediated diseases. It even there's theories that it even can extend to Alzheimer's. So the reach is quite wide for this one. And this is why I think the potential for this stock, I mean, this oral factor D really is like the golden goose here, although it's very early. Here's the current products they have. ORLADEYO for HAE attacks, approved everywhere, basically. They also have Repivap, influenza. In December of 2014, Repivap was approved by the FDA. Repivap is indicated for treatment of acute uncomplicated influenza in patients 6 months and older who have been symptomatic for no more than 2 days. And then here's what they have in the pipeline. BCX9930, the oral factor D inhibitor. It's going to start phase 1 and 2 later this year. BCX9250, an oral ALK2 inhibitor for the treatment of fibrodysplasia ossificans progressiva. And Galidesivir, a broad-spectrum antiviral. This is what is in the pipeline. This is from their JP Morgan Healthcare Conference presentation. They talk about ORLADEYO, launch of ORLADEYO. Quarter three, they want the BCX9930, so oral factor D, and BCX9250, fibrodysplasia ossificans progressiva. Phase one data released in December 2020, safe and well tolerated. So even though they didn't do the COVID thing's not going to happen with this company. You're not going to get the COVID bump. You get something way more important. You get these rare diseases, unmet need, huge unmet need for FOP and for oral factor D, which is just the beginning, just the first indication is going to be PNH. Strong start to ORLADEYO to launch as HAE patients switch to ORLADEYO. $10.9 million in quarter one of 2021 net ORLADEYO revenue. Majority of this revenue came from new patients switching to ORLADEYO from either injectable infused prophylactic meds or from acute-only treatment. The reason why they're switching is because this is what makes ORLADEYO special. It's an oral pill, oral daily use. The other standard of treatments for this are injectables or infusions, which obviously is a lot harder to be compliant with that and more expensive. Physicians expect to prescribe ORLADEYO for over 40% of HAE patients. 80% of HAE patients expected to be on some form of prophylaxis. Significant burden of treatment reported by patients, caregivers, and treating physicians. How patients perceive their prophylactic treatment. Patient is tired of the infusion injection, 71%. Patient is satisfied with his current HAE treatment, but would still be interested in one that is easier to administer, 86%. If you look at LinkedIn, you'll see some of the jobs. So I'm on BioCrista's page. You'll see some of the jobs that they have posted. A lot of it in development. So they're really planning for that phase one oral factor D. They've got director of clinical development. They've got analytical scientist, QA manager, medical science liaison. So this is the person who works between R&D and sales. Senior study manager, research biologist, clinical trial assistant, clinical study manager. We have a press release. There's an upcoming conference, June 17th, Thursday, June 17th, JPM Securities Life Science Conferences. Start getting into the complement-mediated diseases, 9930. So you got PNH, you've got lupus, you've got, like I said, I went on Wikipedia and looked up all the complement-mediated diseases. Alzheimer's is believed to be on that list. Factor D is essential to initiate alternative pathway. Blocking factor D blocks the alternative pathway in all downstream products. BCX9930 is a factor D inhibitor. This is the areas they're going to do it. Hematology, rheumatology, nephrology. Oral monotherapy with BCX9930 offers advantage of controlling both intravascular and extravascular hemolysis. I don't think it's realized the market cap for this. I mean, if you think HAE is great for the ORLADEYO, you know, this is something that can quintuple that, if not more, as far as revenue is concerned with all the applications. And so once they do the phase one, two, and they show safety and efficacy, they're probably going to launch more studies. I mean, look at all the clinical developers and researchers, clinical study managers that they're hiring right now. You don't just hire those people for one phase one/two study, right? You hire those to prepare for more studies. So BCX9930 is one. And then who knows how many other applications, indications we're going to have for BCX9930 besides just PNH. So all in all, I think there is a huge potential here. Again, oral versus infusion is big. Rare disease, PNH, complement-mediated diseases. The BCX9930 program is advancing rapidly. Pivotal trials in PNH to begin in the second half of 2021. This is just what they've announced. They're probably going to announce even more. Then you have fibrodysplasia ossificans progressiva, devastating disease, no treatments available, rare disease that affects approximately 1 in 2 million people worldwide, irregular formation of bone or ossification in muscles, currently no approved treatments, results in a loss of function, deformities, and severely disabling condition. They're in phase one. The phase one healthy subject trial design. You can see the results here. The phase one data released December 21st, 2020, safe and well tolerated. So that is basically what you're looking for in a phase one. And they should announce a phase two to commence sometime, maybe this year, maybe second half of this year, or maybe beginning of 2022. But they wouldn't, this is a lot of people for a company to be hiring on the research side. So this is my thoughts. I think it's got a ways to go. I think there's a lot of potential here. I think it's still early, but I think the cash, in the article we wrote on Latinos in Clinical Research, there is a bear case for this. So here, just to continue the bull case, if BCX993 is approved to treat PNH and related disorders, it could be a blockbuster for BioCryst. Soliris and Ultomiris, which AstraZeneca acquired from Alexion earlier this year, and which are also treatments for PNH and other blood-based immune system disorders, generated a combined $5.1 billion in revenue. There's a lot of potential. You can see the two drugs from Alexion, which AstraZeneca acquired earlier in the year, earlier last year, or earlier this year, actually, generated a combined $5.1 billion in revenue in 2020. Now, the bear case, there's a great deal of competition for HAE. The data for ORLADEYO is not as good as that of TAKHZYRO. An easy-to-swallow capsule, ORLADEYO has some potential to differentiate itself from competition, but perhaps not for much longer. In February, CalVista reported positive results from a phase 2 trial of KVD900, an orally available treatment candidate for acute HAE attacks. As an acute HAE treatment, KVD900 will not compete directly with ORLADEYO. Unfortunately for BioCryst, CalVista is also developing a prophylactic HAE treatment, KVD824, that could end up competing directly with ORLADEYO. But they are in early development for this. I mean, phase 2, by the time it gets to phase 3, it could be years. So ORLADEYO has at least, even the bear case, let's say these KVD gets approved, which is like not guaranteed by any means. This is like 3 to 5 years from now. So ORLADEYO still has, it's still going to be on its own, best in class in the meantime, even in the next 3 to 5 years. And that should allow BCX9930 to develop. And that's really the multi-billion dollar potential. So the market cap for BCRX is about $3 billion as of the time of this recording. So again, just for the complement-mediated diseases, just for the BCX993 oral factor D inhibitor, that, as you've seen from the competition just last year, was worth $5.1 billion in sales, in yearly sales. So that's just for BCX9930. Now you've got BCX9250 in the pipeline as well. And you've got galidesivir for an antiviral for serious viral illnesses. And then you already have ORLADEYO and RAPIVAB, which are generating sales. So the company is stable. The drugs in the pipeline are all promising, all three of them, especially the oral factor D inhibitor. So a $3 billion market cap seems low for this type of company, for this kind of potential. I mean, you could see $10 billion here, at least maybe $6 to $9 billion. So at least a 2 to 3X from this point. So you're looking at, let's call it $15 stock price, even though it's $17. You're looking at $30 to $45 as a potential share price for this. So that's my thoughts on this. Again, not financial advice. I don't encourage you to invest in anything I say, but do your own homework, do your own due diligence. But it's my job to bring you things that I discover. Even if I'm a little late, I still think I'm early because it could still 2, 3X in the next 2 to 3 years. So something to look into, check it out. From those that I've heard, from other site owners that I've heard that work, that have done studies for this company, they love the sponsor, which is a lot to be said. Usually sites don't like the sponsors particularly. These ones all had only good things to say about the sponsor. So for whatever that's worth, see if it's a company worth looking into. Talk to y'all later. Good luck. Bye-bye.